Hello there, everyone. Welcome to another episode of this Wooden Realm campaign. So we have 40 dudes against all of this, and just this is the biggest problem. I mean, just the general and that Camus Shadowguard can do it, because my unit is basically an infantry unit. I think I can hold the ground in at the gates or something like that, but I don't know if that's the best option or not. At least the towers will shoot or something like that. So yeah. But these guys are actually archer units, so I guess not. I guess I want you here. Is there any? Yeah. Well, I can ring around the rosy for a little while, you know. Maybe that'll work out. Yeah. So I'm gonna put these guys here. Left flank always causes more casualties, you know. Don't spend the money on those guys. I mean, these are Dol Guldur archers. Want to hit the bodyguard or the hosts? Honestly, none. Honestly, I want to hit the Dol Guldur hosts. Yeah, that's what I want to hit. There we go. I don't really want to hit the bodyguard. No, the bodyguard doesn't mean that
the enemy are battering down the gates.
That anything will be happening.
The enemy's ram has breached the gates.
So let's go. Yeah, this is a wasted battle, of course. Still,
the walls are no longer ours. The enemy have taken them.
Let's attack the Shadow Guard. There we go. He's attacking with this guy, so I'm just going to move around the Rosie. Hang on, don't really need that. Kabul's Shadow Guard, there we go. They have so many missiles. I mean, these Tawar Arainir. That's cool. Sending some Stalkers, Dol Guldur Archers. As long as I can keep killing some of these Shadow Guard, I'm pretty fine. Yeah, he's now going to the middle, which is what he should. I think I have barely enough time to reach the middle and still be fine with this. Okay, there's some Dol Guldur archers here, so here's what I'm gonna do. Ring around the Rosie, it's always nice. Yeah, there's a couple of guys there who will die. Or maybe not. None is the general, right? I think not. Hopefully they're not. Yeah.
Our foe has taken control of the city.
Yeah. So I gotta move these guys here. I know that my archers aren't gonna do too much, but let me attack
the enemy
here.
Is no longer in command of the city.
You know they're killing this fairly easily, you know. Yeah, they could kill the Murkwood Stalkers. It's not a big deal, you know, it's not the biggest threat or anything. So I think they can actually Yeah, they can kill this before the time ends, so that he can enter easily. Okay, they're under attack by on the back. But the Murkwood Stalkers are nearly dead. Gotta be careful with this. I know that these guys are very powerful, you know. So 1 minute, I can still go in and then get back, you know. Okay, there's no more. There we go. Okay, hang on a second. It's not good because it didn't make any difference there. I need to stop the timer. Whatever happens, I need to stop the timer. Come on. Okay, there's no other option. We're gonna have to fight it out.
Beware! The chance for us to regain control of the city is almost...
Yeah, we're gonna lose it on time, which is kind of bad. I thought I could send in the unit, but it's just too low on units to survive against that. But I still killed 218 men, like 241 guys killed by that. It's nice. I know that the army may have the problem because they have the invasion, so they may have a problem in this band, which would be so cool. There's a general there, there's Kamul's unit there, it's perfect. So let's see. By the rules, it should happen. Okay, so they capture it. I'm gonna recapture it, of course. Then proceed south.
By the light of Elbereth,
immediately go in. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that some of that army got destroyed. I'll just confirm here. Actually, he's sending some units there, here and there, so that's quite bad for me. Noble death, yeah, it happens. Yeah, and I'm still not gaining the money that I needed. Honestly, I'm losing money, so I might as well use it for something else like this. Unless I can use my
yes,
diplomats.
My
hang on.
As you,
hello.
Wish to discuss? It's very well.
Let's see if I can get the same thing. Well, they're bankrupt, so I'm not gonna risk. Even 500 might not be.
No, we can't.
Yeah, see. Even 500 was not. So this guy doesn't need to go anywhere. This guy. There we go. Ended with. Hello.
You hold there is something else you wish to propose then.
They're bankrupt, so I might not get the 500. Let me see.
Seems like a most
accepted.
Deal. Very well.
How about an alliance with 200 or 300?
You hold us at
actually, they got that. And the reason I did this is mostly for the money. I can just destroy the alliance whenever I need. So, town. I have 2,400. What can I build that is interesting? I cannot build the mines yet, 4,000. But that will mean some more money there. Can get the Hall of Song, but that's not really interesting. Yeah, I think I'll just build some communal farmings. Yeah, there we go. Leather Tanner or the Hall of Song. Well, I guess that Hall of Song is better now. Or looks better now. So recapturing this place, hopefully this is gonna get destroyed. I mean, it's 3 turns, I can see that. Yeah. Hopefully they are gonna take it. So let's see. Austin Gael is the first target. It's a village. I'm sorry, it's the last target. It's a village, so I cannot leave one unit there and go and conquer the other place because they will attack it. So, yeah, I have to do that. Oh, he still has the invasion. It's amazing. I don't know how it worked like this. He should have lost lots of units with that. Okay, he's going to give me money even by taking the place, so that's even better. Let me just double check. Yeah, he's ensuring that this place survives.
I shall continue tomorrow. Tomorrow's journey.
He's ensuring that it survives, so that's cool. And I lost all my money. I'm glad that I put my units
my lord,
to do something.
What is it you wish to discuss?
So, map information. You're bankrupt. You might just want to go for 400, so...
I do not believe
just rejected. Amazing.
Yes, my lord.
He's getting really bad at this.
Yes.
Let me talk to Dunland.
Journey planned out.
No threats here, which is perfect, honestly.
Come, my brother. Take it for the elves. Put
okay, but
this evil.
This army can safely destroy these guys. Can clear up the armies, and I don't know, I didn't want Illanin. I can give it back, you know, if needs be. But wouldn't be the best thing. Right? Right. Seriously need this place to grow, but I have to maintain the high tax rates for now.
Follow me.
Especially while Dol Guldur is still, you know, powerful. It's not like some certain factions where you can just go in and capture some places until you're safely on a situation. But this faction, you always have multiple threats from every side. Now let's say, for instance, something like Gondor. Gondor has it very easily, because as soon as they capture this and this, they can just stay back, because Mordor stops being a threat. Now they cannot go all the way around. and you can just concentrate on Harad, for instance. So there are some factions that you can do that. I mean, as soon as you go in and strike at Isengard, Isengard is dead, so Rohan also has it fairly easily, just to grow up a little bit. Or even some other factions, you know, have like Bree or any faction that is over there, it's quite complicated. Any faction that doesn't have a clear path of conquest like this one, you don't really have. You have these ones initially and then it's spread out. Now then it spreads out and it's difficult to maneuver here. So yeah, there's that general, it's still here, which is amazing. Okay, I want to check what kind of units he's building. Yeah, for now nothing. So this should be captured in the next turn, it's easy. Okay, still no messages there. It's interesting looking at the minimap, you can totally see the path that my diplomats did. And it's not a bad one in order to find all. Okay, the Hornberg is under siege. Now I'm just checking, that watchtower was a great decision. Just checking to see what is he doing. So he's gathering forces here in Ostengile, that's not bad. I have some problems with money, that's mostly because of the capture of Boer Alk there. And okay, so Illinin is fairly safe. Now he has lots of troops, so I should actually move in and capture it somehow.
Follow me.
Let's attack this. It's not like I can just survive. There's no other units other than the Kambuls, so that's cool.
Evil must not be allowed to triumph.
And I have so many archers, I mean, they're probably gonna get destroyed with this. Even the Kambuls, they don't have a shield. You know, it's not like he has dwarven-like units. They have armor, but
for
they don't
moment,
have shield, which helps a lot.
Goes our way. Let's pray it remains as such.
Can we use weight because I don't like the fog? Okay, and I have these guys. They're safely away. Okay, the reason why I'm doing this is I want them to be attacking everywhere. But I don't want, for sure, to lose any units that I don't need, you know? Unless I absolutely need to lose them. So yeah. There we go. Now every unit is gonna fire. I'm just gonna leave it like that. Whatever they pick as targets should be fine, you know? Like this host takes one shot, even on a covering position, and it just loses so much. So let's put this on time 6 and see what happens. Those Mirkwood Hunters are probably going to be the last ones. I can even see like the Shamul's Shadow Guards, they're losing severely even though they are very protected here. You know, it's just elves, you know, they hit. Yeah, I have already destroyed half their units, and I lost like a percentage, and that's fine. There's some units who are not firing at all, I'm just gonna send them here. Yeah, look at that. There's for sure no problem here. I'm gonna tell them to attack right now. And I'm going to stop firing. Reason for that is that I really want... No, let me stop firing there. Yeah, I want these guys, who are the last ones with any ammunition at all, to do something. I want these guys here, because they'll be able to hit the Kamuls. And these guys... can group in. It's perfectly fine. I mean, I guess you're gonna go here. There we go. I could attack those Dol Guldur archers, and I think that's actually the best target right now. I don't know if these guys can hit them, but the fact that my Hinudari can just reveals how good this unit is. This guy, I just want them to hit the Camus, it's fine. And the Woodland Spearmen, I mean... I'm gonna put these guys here, because then the Spearmen are gonna move away.
Our men have done well. The gates have fallen.
That way those guys can have a clear shot through the gate. Okay. There we go. Little bit of a shot there, and now they're gonna hit him better. So two, you can fire at will. There we go. Shambled Shadow Guard. They're taking losses. That's cool.
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
There you go. There's some shots going on over there on the Dol Guldur archers. I'm gonna leave it as B. I'm gonna just capture this place.
We've captured the enemy's walls. Our men have slain.
Okay, even killed the general. That's perfect. You're seeing me do some movements here. The purpose of that is just to do this. There we go. There we go.
The battle is very much in our favor. Victory will be ours.
Just gonna hit these Dol Guldur archers there. Should be able to clean them up or soften them a little bit. There we go. I'm six, so that I can finish this up easily. Didn't lose too much, you know, considering things. You're gonna stop firing, you're gonna stop firing. There we go. There's only a Mirkwood Hunter and some Dol Guldur archers here. That's cool.
Our men have taken control of the city.
Yep. These are archer units. They're not good. They're not like mine. They're not good archers. So it's
this
done.
This is a clear victory.
Still lost 41 men. I did get some casualties healed up. But... you know, so many archers, these are better in the melee fight. Like a melee fight, they won't even approach, you know, unless they have wargs or something. So we recovered, finally. They're probably going to send some troops from Ilin in. For that reason, I'm going to send someone who can build a watchtower there, and I'm going to keep that spy there. While this other guy is going to spot what's going on over here. Yep, occupy the settlement. He might have even built something. Could go for the practice range. I mean, why not? There's nothing in over here that can easily stay, so I mean... this guy is going to go over here and build a watchtower. Actually, I can go a little bit further to build it. There we go. Can go away. Now, who's the unit? That's the unit. It's going to stay. There we go. Yeah, I really want to go over here in order to capture that place. So I got some money, got some stuff. I know that I will get that money as well. I don't know if my agents have anything to do. They have.
Without question, as you wish. Yes, your orders.
Okay, let's see if you now you have some money. Even 300 would be enough.
I am not quite able.
Okay, let's go maps for maps.
It was a fair deal.
The pleasure was all ours.
It's cool.
Yes, my lord.
Is that the Variax? Amazing. They actually captured that place. Stopping so here. Cool. Tomorrow's journey
planned out. The one with the Mumakil.
So, I just want to make sure that Ilinin gets captured by Dogwinian, but it doesn't feel like it's the best option right now. So, let me end up the episode and we're going to see everything on the next one. I'm probably going to push here on these two main fortresses or main settlements from Stingyle and this other one, I don't know how it's called. It's Dorlingvar. I need to capture these two places that I have a very clear shot at their capital. That'll probably push away some forces from Ilanin and allow their conquest from Darwinian. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.